So we has an Audi picked up this morning. We got an Audi Q3. It was in for MOT yesterday. They did manage it yesterday. It was one of the last ones through the bay, and unfortunately it failed its MOT on a rear spring. So I've just stuck it up in the ramp there. I've been phoning about. I'm waiting on Arno Clark coming back to me on the rear spring. I have tried TPS. I do know it's available, but it's a factory order, so it's not in stock, so we need to get it for the factory. So we're waiting on Arno Clark. To be honest, they did come back. I had a wee typo predictive text that said our spring, not offside rear, so the guy didn't know what went to price. So it's been advised on the rear disc and the rear pads, and it's been failed on this brake, coil spring. And if we have a little look in there, well, you can see it through there, so you can see that bit there. This is meant to be attached to that other bit of metal that's all rotten down there, so it's broken that spring there. So now you change this spring, there is a service light on it as well, so we need to speak to the customer, see what they want to do, if they want to be service on it as well, and we recommend doing those rear pads and this as well. So thanks for watching. If you haven't already, hit that thumbs up, hit subscribe, and have a great day, okay? Right, so welcome back to the channel again, guys. We have big Audi Q3, there's a Quattro, this one. We've already removed just a little tool, the caps that we can get. It's not what you get this one for another reason. A lot of new pieces are slightly different, so just going with these quality snap-on ones, and that's that one out. Obviously you've seen we did have a bit of a challenge getting the locking wheel key out of the lock box. I think somebody's broken the hinge, the bit that opens the door. So yeah, looking we emptied all the boot, hoping, well, maybe I've been there, but sadly it wasn't. So we emptied all the boot for no reason. And now we'll need to take the boot, all the stuff back out there, they'll get to shut these big buggies. I've been there myself, I bought that big Audi there. It's my first kind of family car, and once you put the buggy in them, yep, big enough car. Once the buggy's in, doesn't matter how big your car is, we need some of these American pickups. They're too big for our roads, mind you. But yeah, certainly have more room in the boot. On the trunk. It's been broke for a while, isn't it? So it's unusual. I've only changed one spring on that car. I did buy a pair, I only changed one at a time. We didn't have time in the workshop, so we quickly got that one back out of the workshop and cracked on with some other work at a time. That one we'll get to, as well as my Honda. So we'll get our new Hopefully. Kearney's on it. Volkswagen. That's Volkswagen sticker. What? Kearney's on it. Stickers. Everyone's on it. So I don't see the markings on it, but the same as. Yeah, they do that. Was a factory order, there was none in stock, not available after market. So not available after market as of yet. We'll try and get all this off it. Try and chip the thing. So I think we'll get this bolt out and we'll get an extender under it. See, so that's that. Sit that there just now. Let's see if we get this. Wow.
good, these ones. They're good for camera stands, because they can spin. But I bought them probably like when I was doing welding and stuff like that. Means you can put it under the sill and take the leg out. There we go, in here, like this. Down a little bit. I've already wired brushed and get that clean. So normally 18s. Yeah. Normally. Okay. Let's see if I really can really get you. Putting a stand underneath the car at the back. Don't just keep jacking it when you're trying to put a new spring in. You need to watch you don't jack the car off the left. So technically what you should be doing is something that's strapped down on the left, but just be careful. You know, I don't want my left up too much. It's just to take attention with the new springs. The old springs coming off. They spring out. So that's what's happened there. We should get it up. Ideally we'd want to take this off with the nut end, but can't get into it, so I'll see what happens. Pardon me, so that's good. I can see I've already wired brushed all of this, so hopefully it just comes out. H, check this one. Yeah, HFH, same kind of thing. And although that one's broken, it does look like the same kind of links, the same kind of thickness. So we'll put the rubber in. It's been sitting up. Get an open bit. Oh yeah. That's the broken bit of it, so you can see how rusty it is. So it's been rusty for quite a while, broken for quite a while, sorry. All our speed bumps in the northern states and stuff like that, guys, now, so... I can see a lot of people just charging through them. Which is good for me. Got a lot of things to do. fixed up any squeaks on the springs. So we'll gingerly keep screwing. Oh. is try and get something on the other side. There we go. Just gonna drive on a bit. Starting to lift the vehicle. Right. And again, we should be tightening on the nut side, but we can't get to it. So just check it. Come here, Uggas, should be enough. Traffic question. I've told them my days of rental traffics are done. You no longer want to see a rental traffic ever again. So I believe that will be his question. How do you fix it? Traffic to stop me. Don't go crazy with the bubbles. We'll use the top end. One day, bad boys. Right, well, that's pretty much done. If you have liked this video, hit a thumbs up, hit subscribe. Have a great day, okay? Wherever you are in the world, have a great day, okay?